Let's stop for a second and compare our old world with the new. Why DAX measures are so much more powerful than the spaghetti of fragile formulas we're used to writing in Excel. Keep watching. So we have seen a basic set of measures, and there are so many powerful things here. So many powerful things. One of them is reuse, right? Not only do you define your measure once and you can slice and dice it any which way you want. And I mean, remember the old way of building reports. If the person asked you, show me sales by category, subcategory, that's all the report was capable of. And then if they said, oh, show me something else, show me by month, you had to kind of go back and redo a lot of times, certainly in a slightly more complex scenarios, maybe not in that one. But in here, you just define sale once and you can bend it to your will. If you've seen Matrix, I mean, gosh, I've seen it, and I can't help but be reminded of that movie. I mean, you can bend reality to your will. So it's really, really cool. You can define your measures once, use them everywhere, not only in any shape of report, but you can reuse them again to define additional measures, perhaps more complex, more awesome measures. So we have variance, variance percentage. And of course, now I can go back and look at our Excel. So here, if I wanted to do variance, you would, in the old world, you would have two separate pivots. And these I call side formulas, side of the pivot, right? So you will say, yep, show me variance would be, let me see, so that's gonna be sales minus budget. So E6 minus I6. All right, so that's your variance there. Now the results are similar. So if you look at accessories bike racks, where is it? Accessories bike racks, variance is 192 for 2016, and that's the right answer. But look what happened here. For just this simple scenario, we have 17 different formulas. That's right, 17, each one is different, right? Each one is different. How far is it from that define once, use everywhere scenario? We already have 16 formulas, and not just that, these are so fragile. I mean, you can break them so easily. You can fat finger over it. Of course, what if you change the shape? I mean, what if you bring in subcategory and, what if you bring in month over columns? Now you gotta redo everything all over again, but not in our case, right? Define once, use everywhere. Once you have variance, you can slice and dice variance any way you want, right? So that's one. And the other one is slightly subtle, and it doesn't appear here, but imagine that when we did the budget, we did not have the caps or the gloves category, right? So what's gonna happen is that caps and gloves are not gonna show up here. Caps and gloves don't show up, but when we started selling, maybe the third month into the year, we came up with caps and gloves. So it was not budgeted for, but we started selling it. And that happens all the time. The one data set doesn't quite perfectly match the other data set in terms of elements involved, right? And think products, think more granular. And then what happens? Our beautiful formula is broken, because guess what it's doing here? It's subtracting cap sales with the jersey's budget. Come on, people, this is broken. And hey, as much as I love Excel, these are the kind of rough spots which just killed me. Just killed me. I mean, because a lot of times I wouldn't pick up on the error. I mean, I would build something with a set of assumptions, but a small, slight change, and I didn't even have to change my report. I mean, imagine you didn't change anything in the report, but suddenly in the system data, caps and gloves show up. You didn't touch your report. All you were doing was hit refresh maybe, but now your report is broken, because it was based on all of these fragile formulas. So guys, I want you to take a moment and recognize how big this is. Because hey, Now, maybe you're saying, hey, Avi, I always knew that. But the key thing is that you got to understand how awesome and epic this is, because believe me, at some point or later, you're going to have to try to convince others. So great, terrific. So we're going to stop here. We have talked a lot about measures, but we're going to talk a whole lot more, and it's going to be epic. Hey, keep watching more videos and keep learning Power BI. But if you did enjoy this video, I would love to hear from you. So leave a comment, like, subscribe, all the good stuff. Power on, my friends.